All right, here we are again. This is the morning time. It's 10 o'clock in the morning, regular business hours. So we got a crowd in the courtroom, or the court, the city hall court. This is the courtroom, or the courtyard. It's not a room; it's a yard. So, we've got motivation to keep a little bit more of a spinner on the energy levels. Although this morning I already did my morning radio program out in the backyard, and I was able to let loose some nice energy. This morning's program was based on number one, breathing and waiting for the words. Yesterday was more of a just fly off the deep end, because it had been about a month since I made a video. So, but Mother Nature always sends her signs, and she will confirm everything that you need to know, and she'll test you too. But these are the things you learn in the law, with the laws of nature. And when you understand that all the city statutes and codes, rules and regulations, local rules, court rules, these are all, were all created by Mother Nature to help society or mankind move from the jungle, where it was a kill or kill be world, into what's called prison planet. And I think they made a movie called Prison Planet. Pretty sure they did. But that'll give you a clue as to how these cities, these counties, these states, these nations are operated. It's all by way of Mother Nature. It's all by way of Mother Nature. And she has a rehab program for every soul under the statutes, codes, and regulations until such time as each individual learns universal law. And this all ties right into what's called, you have to put a claim of lien through a security agreement with your body. You are a spirit. This third eye right here inside of you, which you will learn when you study the Eastern religions. When you make that agreement between your spirit and your body, and you use the legal system, the prison system that you've been born into, to make that agreement so you can get yourself out of the prison system. But you have to prove yourself to Mother Nature under the higher laws, which are explained in the private side of the Illuminati, publicly known as Freemasonry. until such a time as Mother Nature has opened your eyes into the awareness that you have the power with your spirit and your body that you put a claim on that no one can collect from. Once you understand that, then you can create your own world under private universal law. And you will no longer be under the regulations of the prison planet system. And this is the evolutionary Mayan shift that was prophesied that is happening right now. And it's all been made public on YouTube. And the private teacher is Winston Shrout. He is a private military top educational representative for the prison planet public. Now, I am a private military also. My mission is to bring the knowledge to the neighborhoods where the people are at. If you're going to learn from Winston Shrout, you're going to have to go to one of his public seminars to learn this information from him. Or if you have some cash, you can pay him and his office and his help team, and he will guide you through the steps you need to learn so that you can sign yourself out of the prison system as a peaceful individual who is not going out into the public causing harm with your attitude and your physical body. I'm going to tell you something. A judge can smell an attitude 5 miles away before it arrives in his legal courtroom that Mother Nature has given him jurisdiction over every citizen through an assumptive lien position by way of their birth certificate application bond. And a lot of these judges know this. They know they have been endowed by the universe to civilize mankind from the kill or be killed world of the jungle. And if you don't understand what it was like to be in the jungle, I can personally set up a jungle and have it fenced off, put wild animals in there, and set some wild prisoners in there, and put you in there to let you know what it's like to live in the jungle. Kill or kill be world. Just so that sinks in. I just want to emphasize so that sinks into you, so you learn that everything that happens in the kill or kill be world happens because of your attitude. And your attitude is connected to this physical body. And your attitude is your spirit. Now, the thing is, why your attitude is always there is because you don't understand how this earth operates. once you understand that there's a way out to get your freedom, to create your own world, then you can start putting a smile on your face and start dealing with your attitude. Otherwise, you're going to have an attitude to the last day you die. Whether it's hidden in the closet or out in the public for everyone to see. And I'm touching everyone's heart that's listening to me. Because when you go in the closet in your bedroom and you meditate on your bed at night and you analyze your attitudes throughout the day, you've got to get real with yourself like King David. And you got to say, hey, I was mean to that person. Or you got to look in your mind and your heart and say, I call that person a dumb, weakling, ridiculed fool in my heart. And Mother Nature reads your heart and she says, oh yeah, good. You're going to stay in the prison system till such time as you learn how the world works, how this universe works. Now, I am here, and my mission on the private military side, which, by the way, we run the public military. My mission is to open up the eyes to the people here in the neighborhoods where the people are actually at, so that they have a window of hope to see, oh, they can get out of it. And the only way they're going to get out of it is if they work on themselves. And they will start working on themselves once they see the full picture that they can get out. Now they have the motivation to control themselves peacefully because they realize that it's Mother Nature who deals out the beatings. And all these churches that are in this legal system are here for a Mother Nature, Father Cause given reason. They have been commissioned to bring peace in the communities to the people who don't understand what's going on. But the thing is, most of your pastors don't know this. Only the people that are at the top of the chain of the command of the corporate world, who run the churches at a corporate high level, know this information. But like I said, with the Mayan shift, all this information is now being made public to everyone, so that everyone is now on an equal playing field and they can see, oh, okay, now I understand how the universe works. Now I got the motivation. Oh, I got my ticket out of here. I got my ticket to freedom to create my own world. And I'm going to tell you something. When you create your own world and you put a claim, a lien through a security agreement with this body, that is the ticket to eternal life. You have to put a claim on your body to keep it. Otherwise, you're under legal codes. And in the legal code prison system, you are designated to have a birth certificate and a death certificate. In other words, you are under the jurisdiction of man. And Mother Nature is not going to let any slave who does not trust in the higher power. Mother Nature is not going to let a legal servant, slave, citizen live forever while they're trusting in man. And these are the things that you learn when you start to open your mind, open your heart, and ask the universe to reveal the information you need to understand so that you can create your own world, which is ultimately claim your body so you can start living forever. And you can actually astro project yourself through space. You will be given an unlimited amount of power to do what you need to do, but it will be gradually filtered to you. You ain't gonna be given the whole enchilada just like that. You're gonna be tested, and you're gonna go through the proving grounds prove to Mother Nature that you can handle pure freedoms through the steps. But if you want to start your education to learn this information, you've got to go to YouTube and you've got to type in Solutions and Commerce. And you've got to listen to the top private public representative on the private side of the military introduce you through different videos that people have put up from his seminars. And you're just going to get bits and pieces. But you can start to put the pictures together so that it will give you motivation. Call the office and order the seminars for yourself, because the seminars is going to give you front to back from one man with all the paperwork, the templates, and the recommended reading materials. It ain't no different from going to college. You're going to have to educate yourself on the private side of life. You've got to go to YouTube and listen to him so that it stirs your spirit. And if your spirit is not stirred, then you're not meant to be ready yet. You just wait. Your time will come. Everyone has to go through this process. And if you have to die and forfeit your body, so be it. You will just be recycled back through the birth canal again. But you will forget who you are. But you will have the opportunity to remember your past lives, as Mother Nature sees fit that you're ready to handle it. But you've got to go to YouTube and you've got to type this in, Solutions in Commerce, and you've got to listen to Winston Shrout introduce you to your corporate straw man. That is your name in all capitalized letters. Your straw man represents your body. Your body is a corporation. It's a corporation. Think about that. And everybody has a corporate part or a corporate share in all the resources of the planet, including the universe, all the stars, all the planets out there. Everybody has an equal share. But the doorway to get there is to learn the legal system that everything is a corporation. In other words, everything has a form. It has a body. It has a name, and it has a title. When you realize that your body is just a corporation, and you have a title to your body, just like there's a title to a car, there's a title to a house, and in the title it has a description of the house, description of the car. The birth certificate application bond has a description of your body. You have a corporation. It's known as a straw man. Two of the same things. Straw man, corporation, body. It's all the same thing. Let me repeat that. The straw man, the corporation, and the body is all one. It's the same thing. Everyone has a spirit, and your spirit represents thought. Otherwise, in the universe, you have the universal laws. One of the laws is the law of cause and effect. These are universal laws. All you gotta do is go study some of the old pastime scientists, like dude who flew a kite and struck lightning on his kite, Benjamin Franklin, whatever the heck his name was. It doesn't matter what their name was. The point is he discovered something that is universal, that works. And the law of cause and effect was discovered. Whoever it was that found it, you don't even have to know. You could just take some stabs in the air. Was it Einstein? Was it this scientist? Was it that popular name? Was it Pythagoras? Whoever it was, it don't matter. Don't matter who discovered it. Mother Nature got the information to you through a body. A body. A body has a voice. That voice is connected to a spirit. spirit represents thought. And your thoughts, for the most part, are invisible. You can't see them. But you know that they're there. So your thoughts are the cause. And way back when, a long, long time ago, before there were any bodies, a body of a planet, a body of a star, a body of rain, a body of dirt, a body of flesh, a body of rocks, a body of breathable air. Before any of this, a long, long, long time ago, there was the invisible thought realm called spirit. And the spirit had a desire to manifest a body, to experience itself in. But in order for these bodies to grow from an infant stage, when they're first birthed out, when you give birth to a baby, little baby ain't ready to go out and start doing things on its own. When mama gives birth to baby, baby is suckled to the breast, nurtured and cared for, educated and schooled, clothes are bought for the little kid, the little teenager, shelter is provided for little teenager. Otherwise, little teenager's gonna be out there in the jungle. But my point is that little baby, who is a body that was manifested from father thought, little baby that was manifested is a body that needs to grow. So when mankind finally evolved on the scene from a tiny little water creature, because this was a process, man wasn't created like the Bible says. Bible is just a metaphor. It's a picture analogy of the process of coming into manifesting into a body from cause, known as thought. So when you get a body and you finally come into this life, we all started, mankind, flesh started as a little tiny little water creature. He grew into a little frog, little polywog. He came ashore, grew some legs, and evolved from a little hunchback into a caveman, into a bigger caveman. A bigger brain, more thinking capacity. From a monkey to a man. But little baby. watched a little baby when he's born out of the womb. What does little baby want to do?
It's mine! It's mine! Gimme! Gimme! Gimme!
And that's what the jungle was like in the caveman evolutionary process. Tiny little minds with a body. And Mother Nature says, I need to put, or Father Cause, who is the backing behind Mother Nature, who gave us birth from this earth. Father Cause endowed Mother Nature with certain powers over her children that she gave birth to, that she feeds on her breast. And when little baby is held to the breast, and little baby decides that he wants to bite the heck out of mother's breast nipple, mother says, ow, that hurts. Don't bite me. So that's where the discipline system starts right from its get-go, is when baby makes its first bite on the nipple and mama says, ow, no, gentle. It's Mother Nature who takes little baby and raises little baby up into a small child, into a kid, all with the backing of Father Thought, who sits in the background thinking up all the things creatively that needs to happen with that child through the mother. So here we have caveman baby, the infancy of man growing up, although they got big bodies, hair on them, and they can live in the jungle out in the cold, they got brains and they can think. They are just at the infant stage, because they're going, mine, mine. In other words, they're biting the nipple, causing pain in mother. This is mother's domain, her house. You don't run havoc in mother's house, going around children killing each other, punching each other out, calling each other names. But it's going to happen that way anyway. You see? It has to happen. Little baby has to have the freedom to reach out and grab and find out what life's about. So mother says, okay, in order for you to learn and reach out and grab, we got to put some restrictions on you, because I'm tired of you hurting my other children. And you're hurting me. When you hurt my children, you hurt me. And not only that, you start creating all these things with the minerals of the earth, and you start polluting mama's body. Mama ain't happy. When you sling mud poisons on her body, she ain't happy. So she says, all right, young boys and girls, we're going to put you through the prison system. And that's where Father Cause gave Mother Nature the idea to create the cities and counties known as the prison planet. To graduate uncontrollable little baby who grew up to be a tyrant. And mother said, you're going to go to the next level. And this is why we have these prison cities and prison counties, prison states, prison nations. And it's a good thing. It's a wonderful thing. It's the most awesome thing in the world to take people and put them in the prison system. Because it teaches you how to be nice and peaceful with your fellow man. And I'm going to tell you another thing. All these prison cities, prison counties, prison nations are run by the prison warden churches. Because these are the peaceful men in society that know how to keep the peace. Although they have abused their powers, Mother Nature has a program for them also. And that's where the next step of evolution comes in, called the commercial lane. Now that baby has finally outgrown the killer Kilby world of the jungle, graduated into the prison nations, they've become smart, they've become peaceful, but now their urge for power was just a little bit more than they can control. They're still at like a teenager stage in the phase of mankind. And if you've ever noticed a teenager or a young adult, they will abuse their power until someone comes along to show them a discipline system. That is what Winston Shrout teaches. It's the next evolutionary step of mankind to grow into manhood. Responsible, peaceful, fully knowledgeable, fully understandable of how this whole universe works. So when you go to YouTube and you type in solutions in commerce and you start to have your awareness erected in you, you will start to see that these birth certificates that are connected to your body, which is your corporation share. It is your ticket. It is your stock share in all the resources of the planet. And it was put there by way of Father Cause and Mother Nature. Till you reached a time of maturity to understand why it's there. Those birth certificates are there as part of the legal prison planet system. And it is your piece of paper in a public record that says you have a share in the resources of the universe if you understand how to use it. If you understand how to use your body properly, this is your body. It's controlled by your spirit thoughts. And the Eastern side, you'll learn the Eastern side of religion. They'll teach you about your third eye. Your thoughts. When you learn that your spirit and your body have to have a arc connection, just like the Ark of the Covenant, the Ark of Solomon, the Ark that Moses made, it's nothing but a representative of a spark, an arc between the spirit and the body. It's electricity. It is a magnetically founded energetic piece of technology that happens chemically and alchemically between the spirit and the body, and the on and off switch is tied in to that birth certificate application bond. But you have to properly wire it up, the circuit, so that it works. You have to learn how to build. A brand new life into maturity. And your body, or that birth certificate, or your corporate share is being controlled by Mother Nature through the legal attorneys. And you're going to learn this when you study that birth certificate application bond is a trust with three stages: a grantor, a trustee, which is the attorneys, the churches, who look at your life and say, you've grown, you've matured, now you're ready for the trustee. You can look at your life and say, okay, we're going to let you have your piece of the share of the resources of the earth. Seems how you've kind of learned how to control yourself peacefully without the need of some other man coming to you with a belt or a lock and a key to do it for you. And Mother Nature is the one that decides all of this for her children, with all the backing of Father Cause sitting in the background, invisible, making the decisions. When you learn and you've been deemed ready, you will start to inherit as beneficiary the trust resources that have been set aside for you, each and individually, each one of you, when you make that connection, that arc between your spirit and your body, it's called an agreement arc. It's an agreement. It's called a security agreement. You've now grown and become aware of the laws of the universe where you can secure rightfully, lawfully, ownership of your body. That means now you get to call the shots of what's going to happen to your body. You've been given the keys to the Maserati, so to speak. Now you get to drive it around instead of the legal system sitting in the passenger seat saying, turn here, turn here, like the good driver's educational teacher will do. He'll tell you, go here, go here, go here. And if you mess up, he'll say, you need to go here and get rehabbed. He's going to call all the shots in your life till you've become aware to make the peaceful decisions yourself. So, everything happens in this world by agreement. Now, the reason that everyone in the legal system is being told what to do is because they made an agreement with the legal system. But it was a volunteer agreement. And the agreement on the legal system's part is all done by way of assumption. But that's the way Father Cause and Mother Nature intended it to happen. Because you just don't give baby or child keys to the universe. You have to have an enforcement agency overseeing the evolution of mankind with a big gun. Because Mother Nature has endowed certain men with enough smarts and self-control and peacefulness to know that that's what it takes and that's what it's took to evolve men out of the kill or kill be world of the jungle into the safety of cities. Those cities had to be run by a big gun
by a wise man who understood how to keep the peace in the city with the gun. Mother Nature don't give guns to dummies. But if you understand in your nation that you are more than just a dummy, then Mother Nature will give you a gun. So that you can keep the peace in your jail cell, known as your house. Your fenced-in property with four walls is your jail cell in this prison planet. And Mother Nature has endowed you to at least be able to defend yourself in certain parts of the world, especially here in the United States. And if you need to carry that weapon concealed or open carry on your pocket in order to feel safe, Mother Nature has given you an avenue to do that. And especially here in the United States, because the United States is the law enforcement country of this planet. We are the military might that runs the show. Because Mother Nature has deemed us with certain smart men and certain technology to come up with these wonderful weapons to keep peace on the earth. You always have to have that one man, that one person in the family, if you want to bring it down to a smaller microcosm. There always has to be that one person in the family that says, hey, no, we're going to do things fairly and peacefully here. And if you don't keep the peace in the house, you're going to get punished. Has to happen that way. That was the basis of bringing everybody out from the kill or kill pee world of the jungle into the safety of the prison planet system, cities and counties, states, nations. Some nations, the people are not smart enough to hold arms. So the United States went in there and said, strip these people of their guns. Because these guys, this nation has a potential to kill each other off with the guns. And I'll give you a prime example, Australia. If you know anything about the nation of Australia, it is the nation where all the bad prisoners who come out of prison are sent. That'll give you a little history and a little something to think about why Australia is stripped of their guns. Australia is an island country where rehabbed prisoners go to sleep. enforcement country of the world. That's why we are the biggest gun carriers on the planet. Because our root is in law enforcement. It's in our blood. It's in our thoughts. We fully understand. Sometimes in the world of self-defense, in order to keep things from potentially happening, you've got to go in with a gun and say, "Hey, in other words, you've got to display your gun. Just go in, you display it, and the only reason you're going to pull it off your side is because they've moved first, so you got to be quick to the trigger, and that's what all the cowboy movies were all about, to teach everyone how to be quick to the trigger when it comes down to the nitty gritty. You got to have awareness of the people that you're walking around with. If Mother Nature allows that assailant to harm you, don't you go considering pointing a finger of blame at that person and say, "This sucker's out to get me." You better instantly think Mother Nature sent the harm to me. She either decides to save you or punish you because you got an attitude. Because you haven't searched in your heart and said to yourself on your bed at night, "Oh, I called that dude a fool in my heart." That bed that you're lying on was made from the wood that Mother Nature nurtured that's still alive. She hears everything, every thought. You're going around the world thinking to yourself in your heart, "This stupid idiot over there, them suckers, that retarded ass kid over there, that blind sucker over there, dumbass over there, that dude's a fool." Mama Nature. Why am I sick? tracks like? If you got an attitude, more than likely all your friends got the same attitude you got. Cause like attracts like. You ain't gonna see no self-controlled, peaceful judge or attorney hanging down with the friends at Compton. Yes, opposites attract. The only reason opposites attract is to bring balance. When a ridiculing little son over there, or daughter over there, is fingers calling everybody in the neighborhood a bunch of names and making fun of everybody. Old Mr. Attorney, law of attraction. Opposites attract's gonna come in. He's gonna open up your eyes and give you a couple smacks. And probably put you through a three-step program if he has to. As many times as it takes. Till your eyes get opened up. Through YouTube, which is the International Encyclopedia of Information. If you want to learn how this world operates, you type in YouTube search, Solutions in Commerce, and you listen to the top private military representative in the public teach. Of the universe. His name is Winston Shrout. Otherwise, I am the neighborhood representative, private military undercover agent. Who will personally this information to the ears that don't have the know-how to be educated from the public representative through public means. And yes, that's what Winston Churchill does. He goes from city to city. Opposites do attract, only to bring balance. To help you see that like attracts like. Now, what I was talking about was the assumption of agreement. There's an assumption of agreement over that birth certificate application bond. And like I said, Mother Nature put the assumption there on purpose because we had to graduate from the jungle killer Kilby world to these prison, nation, city, county, planets, cells that we live in. And like I said, certain men on the legal side that are backed by men on the private side have set up these legal code systems called rules and regulations of how to teach people how to be safe and nice to each other. So that we can all eventually go through the Mayan shift to the next evolutionary stage of mankind, which is self-responsibility, self-regulations without codes and rules. So you can create your own reality, your own world with your thoughts, to the point where you can even morph into different bodies. astro-project through the solar system and find another planet that's unpopulated and start your own planet population. Yes, this is a gigantic universe of life opportunity to create your world once you understand. Assumptive jurisdiction means there really isn't no agreement written on an affidavit in the public record. And when you realize there are no agreements written on an affidavit in the public record between you and the legal system, therefore you have to create the public record yourself and create these affidavits of truth. So that there is an in-the-record public agreement between the corporation and your spirit, the body and the spirit, a real live agreement on the public record. You've got to put it there. And Mother Nature, once she teaches you how to do this, then you can sign yourself out from under the jurisdiction of the bill collectors and the bank collectors and the body collectors. Because now you're starting to grow in the universe and prove yourself to be self-responsible, self-peaceful, and self-safe. Legal system called prison planet, cities, counties, nation states. And remember, they're built to bring the kill caveman out of the jungle into the safety of cities and have every population of mankind. Because that's all prison is. You go to prison because you're hurting each other. What it was like to live in the jungle. But once you learn your history, where you came from, and understand who you are, and how mankind has grown and evolved, and that we are now at the mind shift, the next turning point in the evolution of mankind, and that is everybody's going to learn how to sign themselves. Individually, it gets more popular, and it will be easier for people to get out. But this legal system we got set up, you've got to sign yourself out with affidavits of truth, witnessed, written in the public record. And you want to learn how to write these things up, you've got to go to YouTube. Listen to Winston Shroud introduce you how to write these affidavits up and to understand. Because if you don't understand your affidavits that you've written, Mother Nature's going to test you to see if you know. And if you don't, you're going to fold under the pressure of the legal gun when the sheriff comes knocking on your door and says, I want to collect your house, your property, your kids, and your body. I don't understand your paperwork that you put in. Then you're going to still be under legal codes till you understand. And if you have to go through sheriff's knocking on your process, servers knocking on your door, court visits, or whatever it takes to prove yourself peaceful and an understanding wise man on the earth, or woman, child, rock, dog, cat, you name it. If you've got to go through the test and fail some tests in order to finally pass, well, trillions of citizens' cells living in your body that you need kingship over. Because those cells are tied to your fist or your tongue that harms another creature. And if you don't know how to be a king of your nation, well, you're just going to be stuck in prison planet world. Until prison planet world finally evolves and everybody comes around. The evolution of mankind, brothers and sisters, is here. It's real. The next third final step is here. That's what the mind shift was all about. All this stuff has been going on behind the scenes in the private realm. But we finally deemed the public ready, grown up and mature enough to give them some tools, some power tools, technical power tools, a little bit complex to learn, but society has proved themselves to be able to learn technical things now, so we can hand this stuff out to the people. The time has come. That's what YouTube is here for. Ultimately, it's to funnel people to the information of private maritime law, known as the law of the universe, the law of attraction. As a man thinks in his heart, so does the universe attract back to him. What you sow is what you reap. Karma. Simple as that. In a nutshell. So, that'll be enough for today's, or this hour's lesson. Till the next lesson, this is Brother Russell, who is PQS, signed off. Oh, I just wanted to add this thing. Once you start to prove yourself as safe and peace, in agreement with the universe, like I said, you will have your access to your share of the Earth's resources. And you can create your own money. In fact, you will be able to open up your own private bank account and have your own private ATM card with just a little bit of money to start off with, and you'll be able to swipe your purchases on that ATM card, and you'll probably be given, depending on what Mother Nature feels and the DOJ attorneys feel, you might be given a couple $100,000 to start off with, and you might work your credit up to $1 million, and so on and so forth. But you've got to prove yourself to be self-responsible, peaceful in your hearts and in your actions, in your thoughts and in your actions to Mother Nature before she's going to give you more and more credit goods on the private side. If you can understand, get a grasp of this is how the world works. And if you're going to church, they'll call this thing God. But there's two different types of church. There's the strict God church, and there's the Illuminati church that has infiltrated the strict God church called the Holy Rollers of you name it, you claim it, it's yours. What you think is what you're going to get. This is the smart church who has infiltrated the dead church. It's true. It's all true what they say. It's just that a lot of them don't know that there is a birth certificate they have to put a claim, a lien on. Otherwise, they're still just a prison citizen. And the law is going to attract to them everything in the legal code system. They will not be given freedom of the universal law to go beyond the legal system. And when you're in the legal system, you are appointed a day of birth and a day of death, and you will die. until you put a claim, a lien on your body and prove yourself to Mother Nature to be responsible, peaceful, not going out and harming anybody with your thoughts and your actions in your heart or with your physical body. Until such a time as you learn these things and put a claim, a lien on your body matched with your thoughts, you will die. You will not be allowed to enter into eternal life where your body will live forever. And that's the point blank solid truth. So remember, there's a false side to the church and there's a real side to the church. Okay? And this all ties into a balance between Western knowledge and Eastern knowledge. So I just wanted to add that in there. So that'll be enough for the lesson for this hour. Until such time, next time. Brother Russell, signing off.